I'm Ali Javanbakht. I'm a family physician. I work for Sansum at their Carpinteria branch. I'm board certified in family medicine. I do outpatient care, which is annual physicals, preventative visits, management of chronic diseases, and evaluating for acute issues. I see the full spectrum of primary care from newborns all the way to seniors. One of the most important topics for me is obtaining and maintaining a healthy weight. Just about everyone's impacted by this problem of obesity. It's a problem in children and all the way through seniors. About 60% of the population is overweight or obese. People who are overweight or obese, they're at risk of health complications. They tend to need to go to the doctor more for management of these health problems. And that's physician time and staff time that could be freed up for other things. And the other aspect of that is people who are overweight and obese and at risk of health problems, they wind up missing more work from having to come in and be seen and complications of their chronic diseases, recovering from things. So it does kind of have a broad impact all around. So if someone's concerned that they might have a weight problem, first thing to do is to confirm if there's a problem or not. And the way we do that these days is based on their body mass index. It's a relationship, a ratio of the height and weight. So at a typical doctor's office, the weight and height are both checked every visit. That gives us the body mass index, lets us know if someone's okay, do they have a healthy weight, are they overweight, are they in the obese category, meaning they're at health risk from their weight. So that'd be a good place to start. Most people actually are pretty aware that they need to lose some weight and they've tried multiple things in the past with varying degrees of success. The next step is to kind of evaluate what has worked before. A lot of people have tried things, some has worked for them, but it's been difficult to maintain. So then the next step is what's worked, what were the pitfalls, and trying to build on what's worked and trying to address those pitfalls. There are a lot of options available. The treatment really needs to be individualized to each person. Everyone's different. It's a matter of finding what works for them. And starting with our primary care provider is a good place to see where they are and kind of guide them along that process. So for coming up with a plan for an individual to keep a healthy weight, maintain a healthy weight, it really does come down to whatever's going to work for that individual person. There's not one single thing that'll make the difference. It's a matter of a number of different things all coming together. Just about everyone knows that it's a good idea to eat well and exercise, but those are really broad concepts. So the more that they can be broken down into really practical, everyday habits, that's where the success can come. So there's a lot of simple things that people can do, and that's part of what we try to elicit from looking at what's worked before. For example, if someone's tried a low carbohydrate diet, they had success with it, but they were unable to keep the weight off. It's still worthwhile to build on that low carb principle, but then modify it to make it work for them long term. It's really difficult to do just modifying eating habits without exercise, really difficult to exercise without changing the eating habits, so really both need to be addressed. When we talk about activity, every little bit counts. Getting off the couch to turn the TV off adds a few minutes to someone's life. So every little bit of movement counts. So the bottom line is making it work for that individual. Some people do well with organized programs like classes for exercise, walking groups, dance classes. Other people like more individual time, so they do exercise on their own, they join a gym. For the people who do individual exercise, the more their exercise time is really set in their routine, the more likely they are to continue with it. There's people who are already active as just by nature of the work they do. People who, for example, work in construction or food service could have a lot of movement built into their day. For those people, a pedometer is helpful. See how many steps they've taken in the day. Really easy to add in steps here and there throughout the regular day to kind of achieve a good reasonable level. So that's where we begin with, and that's where we try to fine tune it to each individual, practical things they can do with their lifestyle that'll fit in. We also look at the rate of weight loss. Generally, a slower weight loss tends to be better. People tend to keep the weight off longer. So about a pound a week is a pretty good rate of weight loss and has the potential for keeping the weight off. A lot of people find that they get frustrated if they don't see results right away and they just abandon their whole plan. What I urge them to keep in mind is eating better, staying more active, even if it doesn't affect their weight itself, even if it doesn't change the number on the scale, will keep them healthier in the long run. So they will have fewer risk of complications of obesity and the chronic diseases that come from it. So the bottom line of keeping them healthier will be accomplished with eating better, being active, even if the number on the scale doesn't change. So fortunately for people who are wanting to maintain a healthy weight and get to a healthy weight, there are a lot of resources available. Starting with a primary care provider is a good place to start to assess where they are with their body mass index, and then the discussion can continue as far as what kind of changes could be made as far as their eating pattern, exercise pattern. There's dietitians that are very helpful. There's health education classes that can be really helpful. For people who have chronic diseases that limit their ability to exercise, like arthritis, sometimes physical therapy can be helpful, coming up with some exercises they can do with their limitations as they are. And then the primary care provider can monitor their progress and fine-tune as needed. So there's a lot of resources available, and people who make use of their resources really tend to do better. So I encourage everyone to use the resources that they have. It's such an important issue that whatever could be done to obtain and maintain that healthy weight is really well worth it. It really does give a lot of return in the long run. So I would urge everyone who is concerned about their weight or think they have a problem to discuss it with their primary care provider. That's a great place to start.